Infertile Land by Markus Meedt. Exterior, barren landscape, day. An empty highway road snakes across a barren landscape, seemingly void of any life. Dead trees and cacti carcasses are throwing long shadows over the cracked soil. With an angry howl, a banged-up pickup truck swerves onto the highway at top speed, swirling up dust into angry clouds. Interior pickup truck, day. A young woman in her mid-twenties, Ellie, is pushing herself back in the driver's seat. Her bony arms grip the steering wheel, knuckles white. A worn baseball cap and scarf cover her pain-contorted face. She's wearing a leather jacket to cover a flimsy hospital gown.
Fuck! No, baby! Not yet, baby! Please! Please! Please!
She pushes her hips toward the steering wheel and begins to rub her belly. She is heavily pregnant. A loud siren begins to blare behind her. Muffled speakers can be heard over her screeching engine. She pushes herself even lower in her car seat, barely looking over the steering wheel, and adjusts her mirror. Through the swirling dust, she can make out several large trucks catching up with her. Military. Exterior, barren landscape, day. A helicopter dangerously maneuvers itself between the six-vehicle large military convoy and Ellie's rickety pickup truck, swirling up the dust. Despite the roaring motors, we can just about make out the message coming from the military vehicles.
Ellie Leon Perez, please stop your vehicle immediately and step out with your hands raised.
Interior helicopter chasing on highway, day. The helicopter pilot hits some switches that blast a giant spotlight on Ellie's car. Interior pickup truck chasing on highway, day. Blinded by dust and light, Ellie bellows a primal scream of pain and frustration. She pulls her baseball cap deeper in her face and looks out the side window, yanking the steering wheel to her right. Interior helicopter chasing on highway, day. A sniper, aka Dart, takes aim at Ellie's car, which suddenly careens off the road and onto the dry desert, crashing through some cacti. The sniper tries to adjust his aim, but Ellie's truck bounces and swerves on the soft terrain. He reaches for his PTT button.
Unable to stop target. She is approaching...
Interior military truck, chasing on highway, day.
The wall head-on.
The voice crackles through the headset of Corporal Ekundayo. Sweating with nerves, he fiddles with his pistol and tries to avoid eye contact with two civilians strapped into their four-point seatbelts across from him. A woman in her late 50s, wrapped into a floral morning gown, rollers loosely hanging in her hair, Cheryl flinches from the hand pressure applied by Dwayne's sweaty worker hands. Dwayne grips tighter as he tries to calm his breath. 5 seconds in... 5 seconds out. Though only in his mid-twenties, his weathered features age him drastically. Cheryl painfully wiggles her squeezed hand free and turns her attention to the corporal.
Are we going to see the wall too?
Not if we catch her first.
This snaps Dwayne out of his trance. He's about to interject when their vehicle sharply pulls off the street and onto the rocky ground. Corporal Ekundayo drops his pistol and bang! Interior pickup truck chasing on highway, day. Ellie grunts loudly, covering the echoing sound of the gunshot. The motor sputters sickly. A bobblehead puppy with huge eyes shakes uncontrollably on the dashboard.
Fuck off!
She tears the bobblehead puppy off the dashboard and throws it out the window. Exterior barren landscape, day. The toy flies out the window and instantly gets crushed by the convoy. The camera spins up into an aerial, pulling back when a blue light begins to creep into the frame in the distance. Interior helicopter chasing on highway, day. Dart lowers his gun and looks up as blue light washes over him. Interior military truck chasing on highway, day. A blue bullet-sized light shines into Ekundayo's eyes through the bullet hole between Cheryl and Dwayne's shocked faces. Interior pickup truck, the wall, day. Ellie is washed over by the pulsing blue light. She shields her eyes with the baseball cap, tears running down her cheek. Her breath quickens and her foot comes off the accelerator. We see what she sees. A blue infinite wall creeps across the barren landscape, so vast there is seemingly no end to it in any direction. White lightning explodes within it. Slowly, this infinite shield pulls across the land centimeter by centimeter. Ellie takes her hands off the wheel in awe. The pickup truck sputters and slowly rolls to a halt. Exterior barren landscape, Levon's truck, day. The convoy screeches to a stop at a safe distance between Ellie's pickup truck and the wall. The door of the leading convoy vehicle swings open and a heavy boot descends onto the dusty ground. A muscle of a man, despite his age, lifts a megaphone to his bearded face.
Ellie Perez, please remove yourself from the vehicle. We will send some help your way and return you to a hospital. We are here to help you, ma'am.
As his authoritative voice echoes over the noise of the helicopter and the thuds and thunder of the wall, soldiers pour out of the convoy vehicles and take position with their rifles raised behind vehicle doors and shields, aiming at the pickup truck, or aiming at the wall. Interior military truck, the wall, day. Duane and Cheryl both fight over a peek through the bullet hole, wiggling in their seatbelts. Duane gets there first.
Jesus, man, just say please.
Corporal Ekundayo, oblivious to their childish quarrel, is looking for his pistol under the vehicle benches. Interior pickup truck, the wall, day. Ellie tears her eyes off the wall in front of her and watches the soldiers through the side mirrors, guns raised, locked and loaded. She adjusts the rearview mirror to get a better view of the man with the megaphone. Interior military truck, the wall, day.
What are they doing? Why are they aiming their guns at her?
Scared, he turns to Corporal Ekundayo.
Sir, you have to tell them to put their guns down. They're just scaring her. Hey, they need to fucking back off. Tell them to back off, you fucking idiot.
Duane tries to unlock the seatbelt, but fails miserably. He grows more desperate and angry with each attempt. Ekundayo stops his search for his gun and towers over the little man stuck in his seatbelt, trying to gain some authority.
Sir, please let us do our job. We're just trying to help.
You just nearly shot us in the face. How are you helping? What's the matter with you people?
Cheryl softly puts a hand on Duane's leg. He settles back down and glares at Ekundayo, who still tries to stand tall in the cramped vehicle.
I'm sure everyone is trying their best. Aren't we?
Ekundayo reluctantly sits back down.
There you go, boys.
She speaks calmly and with a smile, seemingly oblivious to the intensity of the situation. Neither one of the men notice how Cheryl slowly tucks the pistol under the bench with her feet. Interior pickup truck, the wall, day. Ellie is contemplating her next move. She reaches for her mobile phone. Hundreds of missed calls and notifications pop up on her home screen. She opens a text chain to Duane and starts typing. I am sorry it came to this. I just want her to have a future. Send. There is no future here. Send. Tears are now rolling down her face. She's trying to calm her shaking hands. I love you forever. Send. She sends a sticker emoji looking like her, both thumbs up, subtitled, Go get them, Tiger. Only then does she notice that she has zero reception. Nothing she can do about it now. She reaches for the car keys and tries to restart the car and tries again, but the motor just sputters before it dies back down. Fuck. Exterior, barren landscape, the wall, day. Levon glances through his binoculars.
I think the car's a goner. Dart, do we have clear visuals on the target?
Interior helicopter, the wall, day. The helicopter half arcs around the car. Dart pulls UV sunglasses over his eyes to shield from the brightness of the blue light and looks through the visor. He reaches for the PTT.
Negative, boss. We can't get any closer to the wall.
I can try and wiggle in a touch, but we are already getting a lot of interference.
Exterior Levon's truck, day. Levon looks towards the helicopter swinging around the car. Little lightning bolts split off the wall towards the helicopter, like eager arms reaching.
Please, no risk-taking just yet. Let's roll out lover boy. Ekundayo, you're up. Bring them both.
Interior military truck, the wall, day. Ekundayo reaches for his PTT to respond, stops to take a deep breath and clears his throat.
Now?
Deafening silence on the line.
I mean, sir. Yes, sir.
He carefully begins to unbuckle Dwayne, trying to keep his distance.
Very helpful, sir.
Dwayne gets up from the bench and squares up to Ekundayo. The full size of Dwayne's bulky frame suddenly becomes very apparent. Cheryl waits her turn, licking her lips like an excited child. The tail of the truck begins to lower as the blue light washes over their faces. Both men shield their eyes for a moment. They don't see Cheryl dipping down and back up, fastening her morning robe tightly, hiding the gun. Exterior, Levon's truck, day. Cheryl, Dwayne, and Ekundayo step out of the military truck and are greeted by several soldiers with their weapons up, but the guns aren't aimed at them. Like a protective shield, the soldiers keep circling around the trio as they walk towards Sergeant Levon. Levon looks through his binoculars towards Ellie's car. He takes a sharp, short breath before he turns to... Cheryl suggestively raises an eyebrow, impressed as Levon reaches his hands out towards her, all smiles. There's even a bit of a spring in his step.
Miss Perez, Mr. Levon, are we glad to have you here with us?
He enthusiastically shakes Cheryl's and Dwayne's hands.
I know this must be very unnerving to you both.
He nonchalantly nods towards Ellie's car and the wall.
We do try to keep civilians away from the wall as much as possible, but you can imagine that under these circumstances we need every help we can get.
Dwayne pays no attention. He keeps staring at Ellie's car standing only 100 meters away from the slowly creeping wall. Cheryl is all smiles, though. She looks in amazement between Levon and the wall.
We want to make sure everyone is safe and gets home, to and with their family.
He nods to Dwayne and Cheryl respectively. He reaches out his hand and, as on command, one of the soldiers passes him a clipboard.
So let me tell you what we know.
Montage, hospital. Interior, military hospital, corridor, pregnancy testing, day, flashback. Dwayne rushes down a mostly empty hospital corridor. He stops in front of a door with two soldiers standing guard. One of the guards does a quick security pat down, and Dwayne pushes past them through the door. He's followed by one of the other soldiers. Protocol.
1100, we got the heads up from the pregnancy ward that they will induce labor.
Interior military hospital, Ellie's ward, day. Dwayne stops in the room and sees Ellie surrounded by an obscenely large amount of doctors and even some camera crew. When Ellie sees Dwayne, she immediately begins to cry. He pushes past the doctors and cameras to hug her.
At 11:45, during a routine check, Miss Perez demanded a private moment with her partner before the birth.
The soldier in the room tries to pull Dwayne away from Ellie, but Dwayne doesn't take long to fight back. Ellie whispers to one of the doctors, who nods. The doctor opens the door, and everyone but Dwayne and the soldier leave. Interior military hospital, Ellie's ward, later. Ellie is hyperventilating in Dwayne's arms. Suddenly she screams. The contractions have started. Dwayne throws a panic look towards the soldier standing guard in the room, who immediately jumps into action, shouting down his radio and pulling a wheelchair out from the corner.
At roughly 1200, we were notified that there seemed to be an emergency.
Interior military hospital corridor, pregnancy testing. Dwayne pushes Ellie on her wheelchair past the doctors and news teams waiting outside the room. The crowd jumps into a frenzy and runs after them. We stay on Ellie, who takes in her surroundings. Camera flashes painfully light up the space around her. She catches a glance of the viewing window to the baby incubator ward. All the beds are empty. The lights are off. Through another window, she can see a huge crowd waiting outside the hospital window. They're holding banners and flags. A demonstration? A celebration? Ellie looks the other way down a dimly lit corridor to see... Interior military hospital corridor, child testing. A group of hungry and scrappy-looking 8 to 16-year-olds and their parents are lined up along the corridor. A young girl exits a room. There are little plasters all over her body. The girl turns to see what all the ruckus is about and locks eyes with Ellie. Her little red eyes suddenly begin to glow with excitement as she notices Ellie's big belly. Ellie begins to tear up with heartbreak. It's just a split-second moment, but it feels like a lifetime. Interior military hospital delivery room entry. They come to a halt outside the delivery room. A doctor bursts out of the delivery room, blocking the way. As the door swings open, we see news teams crowded around the labor hospital bed.
The hospital had a delay setting up the labor room due to the ongoing demonstrations.
Ellie is screaming in pain. Duane tries to argue with the apologetical medical staff. He's about to lose it when Ellie reaches for his hand, a moment between them. Duane's aggravated body language instantly crumbles. He takes off his jacket and places it over Ellie's exposed legs. Duane warmly smiles, but Ellie's breath quickens. A panic attack is in full swing. The doors to the labor room swing open again. Camera flashes light up the room. Duane shields his eyes and tries to protect Ellie from the onslaught of bright flashes. Overwhelmed, Ellie frantically tries to push her wheelchair away from the room. Suddenly, a fire exit at the end of the corridor bursts open and a horde of people pour through. They're cheering and waving large flags and banners. In the chaos, we can just about make out some of the cryptic slogans. Life has returned. A holy child is born. The first birth of many.
The premise was breached by speculators shortly after.
The military men try and shield Ellie. The journalists pour through the delivery room door to get a better snapshot of the chaos. Duane tries to fight off the masses of people descending on Ellie. Close on Ellie, Ellie watches the chaos unfold around her. She slowly gets up from the wheelchair, whole body shaking, eyes wide with terror. She stumbles toward the wild crowd of demonstrators and military who push and pull her unknowingly. But somehow, she just slips through and puts on Duane's leather jacket. Leaning against the corridor railing, she walks toward the fire exit. Amongst the chaos, no one has actually noticed her leaving. Duane's fists are flailing. Soldiers push some of the fanatics on the floor. The wheelchair stands empty amongst the raging bodies.
The breach was back under our control within 2 minutes. But amongst the ruckus, your wife vanished. The initial assumption was that someone had taken her by force.
Exterior hospital entrance, day. Ellie emerges from the hospital door, walking past the oblivious security staff, holding back the celebrating crowd. She pushes herself through the people who cheer some of the slogans we've seen on the banners. Life has returned! Ellie gets pushed over by a particularly excited man. She holds her belly tightly and gets up, pushing through the end of the crowd into a parking space. Instinctively, Ellie reaches into one of the jacket pockets and reveals a set of car keys.
But after closer investigation of the security footage, she was seen leaving the hospital.
End montage. Exterior, barren landscape.
In your car.
Sergeant Abraham Levon turns to Duane, his tone heavy with accusation. Duane's about to interject, but Cheryl gets there first.
Amazing how no one noticed. Isn't that amazing, Mr.?
Sergeant Levon.
Cheryl flirtatiously salutes. Duane is not impressed. One way or another, the situation is diffused.
And, Sergeant, why did you bring us out here on this exciting rescue mission?
Levon takes off his hat and wipes his face with a cloth. He didn't expect to be so effortlessly undermined by this little civilian lady with rollers in her hair.
As you can imagine, we are highly concerned about the mental and physical state of your daughter and of the child. I'm sure you understand how important it is that this birth goes smooth. We need her to return to the hospital.
Interior pickup truck. Ellie rubs her belly, controlling her breathing, scanning her surroundings.
The first birth in 7 years. 7 long years without any new life. Your daughter, your partner, and her child. She can bring new hope to humanity.
Interior helicopter. The pilot works hard to keep the helicopter steady, switching buttons, adjusting the control stick. The blue wall reflects in his sunglasses.
New strength to fight back this wall, this all-destroying beast.
Exterior, barren landscape, the wall. The wall slowly crawls over a dried lizard carcass. Before it vanishes altogether, a spider crawls out of its mouth.
7 years this world has grown smaller. And suddenly, new life.
Exterior, barren landscape, Convoy HQ. Sergeant Levon holds a megaphone out to Duane and Cheryl.
We need your help to return Ellie safely.
Cheryl is about to reach for the megaphone, but Levon pulls back.
One way or another, we will save the child.
The warning hangs heavy. Cheryl hesitates. Dwayne snatches the megaphone and pushes past Levon.
Ellie? El, I'm here. What are you doing?
Interior pickup truck. Ellie jolts in her seat. She readjusts the mirror and finds Dwayne in the distance, staggering towards the car. Two soldiers block his path.
No.
Exterior, barren landscape, convoy HQ. Dwayne tries to push himself past the soldiers.
That's far enough, friend.
Dwayne turns to Levon, confused.
Tell her to back away from the wall. It's dangerous.
El, you... come. You need to come back with us.
The soldiers take a step back and relax. Dwayne takes in his surroundings, the soldiers, the wall, the guns, the lightning. Interior pickup truck. Ellie instinctively reaches for the door handle but stops herself.
I know you're scared, but...
Exterior, barren landscape, convoy HQ. Dwayne spins around trying to find the next words in the dead and barren landscape. He locks eyes with Sergeant Levon, who nods encouragingly.
I love you!
Interior pickup truck. Ellie's hand hovers over the door handle. She doesn't know what to do.
I love you, Ellie!
Gently, her hand glides off the door handle.
I love you too, Dwayne.
And reaches for the car keys one more time, twisting them in the engine. The dashboard lights flicker, but die back down.
Fuck.
She leans her head on the steering wheel, closes her eyes, and tries again. Exterior, barren landscape, convoy HQ. Dwayne sees the car lights flicker on and off. Gobsmacked, he drops the megaphone. Sergeant Levon seems relieved. That's all the negotiating he needed.
Fuck it. We are moving in.
He reaches for his PTT.
You four take out wheels. You one, advance with me. Dart, in position for tranquilizer. The moment she gets out of the car, you take the shot. Get medical unit standing by for surgery.
Bang, bang! Two shots rip across the landscape. The bullets rip through the back wheels of the pickup truck. Cheryl shrieks and backs into an equally stunt Corporal Ekundayo. Dwayne tries to push through the two soldiers blocking his way. They push back with force and point their rifles straight at his face. The helicopter readjusts its trajectory and whirls the sand up dramatically, blocking the view between the pickup truck and Sergeant Levon, who's advancing with four soldiers in formation, rifles raised. Interior pickup truck. The wind catapults a stone into the windshield. Crack! With shaking hands, Ellie tries the keys again and again.
Baby, what should I do?
Exterior, barren landscape, convoy HQ. Cheryl shields her eyes from the dust and sees Levon disappear in the cloud. She turns to Ekundayo with an apologetic shrug and kicks him in the crotch with all her might. Exterior, barren landscape. Levon and his men advance quickly through the sandy cloud when a voice screeches through his earpiece.
Mr. Levon, did you truly drag me out into this desert just to watch you violate my pregnant daughter?
Levon stops in his tracks and lifts his fist, his men stopping in an instant.
I can't see you very well, but I assume you stopped.
Levon and his men give each other a confused look.
Hello? Do I press this right? Hello?
Exterior, barren landscape, convoy HQ. Cheryl sits on top of a knocked-out Ekundayo holding his radio.
Hello, hello, hello. Stop.
Exterior, barren landscape. Levon, perplexed, reaches for the PTT.
Miss Perez, I have about 50 soldiers with a mother complex who will happily take you out of my command. So please, tell me why they shouldn't.
Well, I just sort of assume that you went out of your way to pick me up, because you know very well that mothers know best.
Exterior, barren landscape, convoy HQ. Cheryl lets go of the transmission button and waits patiently as soldiers surround her and Ekundayo.
Speak.
Don't waste your precious men and risk your own life so close to the wall that you yourself said is very dangerous. Just let me go to my daughter and talk to her.
Why do you think she'll listen?
Cheryl confidently winks at one of the soldiers creeping in on her.
Because she is scared. And because I really want to meet my grandchild.
Cheryl waits with anticipation for a reply. The soldiers around her move their fingers from the safety onto their triggers when...
I give you exactly 2 minutes to get her out of the vehicle.
Levon emerges from the dust. His soldiers pull a stumbling and bleeding Duane across the sand. Cheryl gets up, victoriously. Interior pickup truck. Ellie unbuckles her seatbelt, gently holding her belly.
What are we doing? Why did you bring me here?
She reaches for the door again, ready to make a run for it. Exterior barren landscape pickup truck. Cheryl walks toward the pickup truck. She looks over her shoulder, feeling Levon's eyes on her, and then up at the helicopter. She throws a friendly wave to Dart and accelerates her casual stroll to a lackluster jog. Interior helicopter. Dart readjusts his rifle from the waving Cheryl back to Ellie's car. The door begins to open.
Dart, if you get a clear line of sight, the command stands. Fire at will.
Interior pickup truck. Ellie begins to push the car door open by a sliver when another painful contraction travels through her. She controls her breathing and fights through it, slowly. Exterior, barren landscape pickup truck. Cheryl sees the car door open and smiles. She tightens her dressing gown and starts to run as fast as her legs allow. Interior helicopter. Dart has his eyes on the car door opening, but he can't quite see Ellie through the window. The helicopter swerves momentarily, avoiding some of the lightning protruding from the wall. Interior pickup truck. Ellie has managed to slow her breathing when she notices her mother in the side mirror.
Marmee?
Cheryl waves frantically. Ellie begins to push open the door. Exterior barren landscape pickup truck. Cheryl mouths, "Stay in the car," but interior pickup truck. Ellie pushes open the door. Exterior, barren landscape, convoy HQ. Levon watches through his binoculars. Interior helicopter. Dart takes a deep, sharp breath, eyes on Ellie. Interior pickup truck. Ellie tries to heave herself out of the seat.
Marmy!
Exterior, barren landscape pickup truck. Cheryl throws herself against the car door, pushing Ellie back in. Interior helicopter. Dart retracts his finger.
Mother.
Exterior, barren landscape, convoy HQ. Levon grinds his teeth, knuckles white on the binoculars.
Fucker.
Interior pickup truck. Ellie tries to open the door again, but Cheryl leans against it, smiling from the other side of the window.
Marmy! Mom!
Elizabeth!
Cheryl smiles warmly through the window. She signals to lower the window.
Mom, just let me open the door.
Just a smidge, love.
Ellie reluctantly rolls down the window.
Marmy, what are you doing here?
I came to see the wall. What are you doing here?
Ellie is stumped. She stammers, but has no answer.
Are you okay, love?
Ellie shakes her head, tears rolling down her cheeks again.
No.
Ellie begins to sob.
Why are you here, Elizabeth?
I think... I can't. Not like this.
Cheryl gently puts her hand against the window.
Full sentences, Elizabeth.
Ellie laughs, being mothered at a time like this.
You think...
I think there is life behind this wall, no matter what they say. Ever since I got pregnant, I've had these dreams. I can't...
Ellie falters.
You can't...
I can't give birth to this child in a dying world. It would be cruel. It would be, and you know it would be.
But the wall will kill you, dear. It kills everything.
Ellie contemplates.
No, Mom. This side of the wall kills everything. We don't know what's on the other side.
Are you sure you want this?
Ellie nods.
What about the idiot farm boy who loves you?
I love him. But I love this child more.
Exterior barren landscape, convoy HQ. Levon looks at his clock.
T-minus 30.
Interior pickup truck.
What should I do now?
Cheryl takes her hand from the window and smiles proudly.
Now you need to do what you think is right.
Ellie nods confidently when Cheryl suddenly pulls the door open, holding Ekundayo's gun at Ellie's head.
And I will do the same.
Interior helicopter. Dart sees Cheryl point the gun into the car. He looks over the visor. Is he seeing what he thinks he's seeing? Exterior, barren landscape, convoy HQ. Levon drops the binoculars.
Who is this woman?
Duane watches in shock as Cheryl pulls Ellie out of the pickup truck, gun to her head. Exterior, barren landscape, pickup truck. Confused, Ellie is looking down the barrel of the gun.
Honey, you know I just want to see you happy.
What are you doing, Mom?
Cheryl's Cheshire grin widens.
I am kidnapping you?
Ellie grits her teeth, her legs giving in for a brief moment.
All right, Lizzie. Let's get you out of here.
Cheryl pulls Ellie into an embrace and gently spins her around. She puts the gun to her head and slowly begins to pull her towards the wall. Exterior, barren landscape, convoy HQ. Levon hurls the binoculars against the HQ truck.
What the fuck is happening? Take her out! Take her the fuck out!
Dwayne pulls himself up to his feet, trying to make sense of the situation. Interior helicopter. Dart is taking aim again, but Cheryl's frail body is mostly blocked by Ellie.
Sergeant, negative. Too much risk.
Exterior barren landscape pickup truck. Ellie and Cheryl are moving at a snail's pace towards the wall.
Take short, quick breaths and lean into me. I can hold you. Don't you worry.
Ellie's breath quickens. She wraps her fingers around Cheryl's arm across her chest and leans into her mother. A trusting embrace between daughter and mother, if she wasn't holding a gun.
Listen, you are the most important person in the world right now. They will come at us any minute now. When it comes to it, you need to run. Can you do that?
Ellie nods, her eyes wide in terror, noticing the full number of soldiers surrounding her for the first time. Exterior, barren landscape, convoy HQ. Levon is loading his gun while speaking into his PTT.
Dart, take the fucking shot. You four, let's go.
Levon pulls the safety of his gun and breaks into a sprint towards Ellie and Cheryl. Interior, helicopter. Dart and the pilot nod at each other in unison. They need to come in closer. The helicopter edges closer to the wall. Exterior, barren landscape, the wall. Ellie and Cheryl are slowly approaching the wall. Little lightning bolts snap out of the blue surface like reaching hands.
Mom, what if I'm wrong?
Then you die.
Cheryl stops and lets go of Ellie. She places herself in front of her like a shield and takes aim at a fast-approaching shape in the dust. The wind gust of the helicopter intensifies around them.
But I am so glad you are brave enough to find out. Now go, before you change your mind. I love
you. Bam! A bullet zaps through Cheryl. Interior helicopter. Dart reloads the rifle. Exterior, barren landscape, the wall. Ellie's heart sinks as she watches her mother drop to her knees. As Cheryl falls, Sergeant Levon is approaching at full speed behind her. Ellie freezes like a deer in a headlight as Levon runs straight at her.
Dart! Tranquilize her!
Interior helicopter. Dart takes aim when suddenly blue lightning blasts through the side of the helicopter. Splash! The pilot explodes like a microwave tomato. The helicopter spins out of control, alarm beeping. Exterior, barren landscape, the wall. Blue lightning whips at the out-of-control helicopter, seemingly pulling it into the wall. It explodes in a burst of fire. The explosion lifts Ellie and Levon off their feet. They topple to the ground. Ellie shields her belly and grunts as she slides across the sharp stones. She tries to get back on her feet, but there's just too much pain. She is on all fours, breathing hard, blood dripping from her forehead, when two boots stop in front of her.
Enough. Enough now.
Sergeant Levon towers over Ellie. He kneels down to be face to face with her.
It scares me to think that the future of our species relies on a child coming from a woman like you.
Ellie contracts. She does a primal scream, locking eyes with Levon. She is blood and spit and fury. The lightning from the wall grows more and more erratic behind her.
I will make sure they lock you up far away from this baby.
Levon grabs her arms and pulls her up in one swoop, when suddenly a body flies into him. Dwayne, arms cuffed behind his back, violently crashes on top of Levon.
Ellie, I understand. I understand. Run!
Levon's fist pushes through Dwayne's face, but it doesn't quite throw him off. Dwayne headbutts the older man with everything he's got. Ellie turns and limps toward the wall. Bravely, certain, step by step, she gets closer, the blue light washing over her face. We see Levon rising up behind her, blood gushing from his nose. He stumbles after her, reaching out. But the blue lightning lashes out around Ellie. It pulls at her hair and her clothes and suddenly pulls her into the wall. Light washes over her. Exterior, the other side of the wall. Ellie slowly adjusts to the blinding light. She can only make out soft silhouettes in the overexposed fog. She stumbles to her knees onto something soft. Grass?
Oh!
She buckles from the pain of her contraction and rolls onto her back. The baby is coming, and there's nothing she can do about it. She begins to push, unaware of the strange humanoid silhouettes appearing around her, unaware of the ground shifting underneath her to make her more comfortable, unaware of the otherworldly noises, her eyes closed, her breathing shallow, one final push. Fade to white. Exterior, barren landscape, the wall. Soldiers run for cover, hiding from the violently pulsating wall. Faster than ever, the wall extends across the landscape. Lightning whips over the convoy vehicles, tearing them in two. Levon crawls backwards, trying to get to his feet. Dwayne lies on the ground, one eye swollen shut. Motionless, he stares at the now fast-approaching wall, swallowing everything in its path. 3 meters. 2 meters. 1 meter. He closes his eyes, bracing himself for the end. When the wall collapses in on itself, evaporating into a light mist. The wall has vanished. Dwayne opens his eye. Confusion, shock, realization. He pulls himself up, taking in the sight. Levon takes off his hat and drops it in disbelief. A lush and vibrant jungle of prehistoric plants stretches out across the land that was beyond the wall. Right at the edge of the greenery, Ellie sits in a meadow of moss and flowers, holding her newborn child, still attached by the umbilical cord. She looks like an emperor sitting on a throne, a whole new world behind her, a world that, for a brief moment, belongs to only her and her baby, a world full of life. The end.